Greenhouse gas emissions continue to rise, aggravating the climate change crisis, which degrades nature but also our health and global economies. About half of the global emissions come from extracting and processing the world's material resources. By 2060, the use of materials is expected to double. Renewable energy and energy efficiency have been the main focus of tackling the climate crisis. But this can cover only 55% of global emissions. The remaining 45% comes from producing the cars, clothes, food, and other products we use every day. GACERE, the Global Alliance for Circular Economy and Resource Efficiency, is committed to support global just circular economy transitions and more sustainable management of natural resources by demonstrating how circular economy offers cost-effective ways of reducing greenhouse gas emissions. Circular economy implies a systematic transformation of the way we design, make, use, and dispose of products. The textile industry generates 3.3 billion tons of greenhouse gas per year. Circular design, use of secondary raw materials, recycling of mixed fibers, managing hazardous chemicals, fostering reuse and repair services are circular interventions which can reduce emissions of the sector.
Textiles are a key priority for the EU. This is a sector that employs millions of people, generating billions of euros in added value. In fact, it's the fourth highest pressure on the environment and climate. Imagine that every year, every EU citizen is throwing away some 11 kilos of textiles. We actually lose more than 100 billion US dollars worth of materials each year. So it's time to turn that around and make sustainable and circular textiles the norm. Our goal is to see circularity designed in from the start, with textiles that get used for longer and are easier to repair. Changing the way we produce, consume, reuse, and recycle require global efforts and commitments. And as member or friend or partner of the Global Alliance on Circular Economy and Resource Efficiency, join us finding the solution to pave the way for the textile revolution.
Plastic production and incineration of plastic waste generate 400 million tons of carbon dioxide each year. Integrating the life cycle thinking into the design, production, use, and disposal of plastic products is essential to reduce impacts on climate, ecosystems, and health.
El Perú tiene dentro de sus políticas prioritarias la transición hacia una economía circular. Nos encontramos en el momento perfecto para asegurar que la economía circular se incorpore de manera integral en el Tratado Global de Plástico a través de los siguientes enfoques. Enfoque de prevención en todo el ciclo de vida de los plásticos para reducir o eliminar la contaminación plástica en el ambiente. Para ello se debe considerar la eliminación gradual, reducción y reutilización de los plásticos. También debemos tener el enfoque de la gestión de residuos orientada al reciclaje y la responsabilidad extendida al productor, así como el enfoque transversal orientado a brindar educación e información, generación de fondos para la innovación y desarrollo para brindar soluciones tecnológicas para la sustitución de plásticos. Estoy convencida que el Tratado Global permitirá desarrollar acciones concretas para que el sector de la industria plástica consolide su transición hacia una economía circular justa y con enfoque territorial.
Norway is a country with a high material footprint, so it's very important for us to reduce that going forward, find concrete measures that can contribute. We recycle 28% of plastic packaging going forward. We need to put in place measures that can increase that amount in the future. But at the same time, Norway is a small country. We're 5.5 million people, and we import most of the plastic that we use today. So it's important for us to engage with the international community to find a legally binding plastic treaty. We know from the study commissioned by the Nordics countries that we in 2040 can reduce emissions from plastic pollution by 90% and that we can increase the circular value chain within plastics substantially. but then we need to work together to put in place the global plastic treaty and find the right measures globally going forward.
Au Canada, par exemple, nous prenons une série d'actions tout au long du cycle de vie des plastiques. Nous avons aussi interdit les produits de plastique à usage unique néfastes. Nous mettons également en œuvre des règles d'étiquetage. Finalement, on investit également dans l'innovation. Nous estimons qu'une économie circulaire pour les plastiques pourrait réduire les émissions de carbone du Canada de 1,8 million de tonnes par année, tout en créant des emplois et en générant des milliards de dollars d'activités économiques. Mais je suis convaincu que nous pouvons en faire beaucoup plus ensemble pour relever le défi à l'échelle planétaire. C'est pourquoi le Canada est en faveur de négociations internationales pour avoir un accord mondial juridiquement contraignant sur la pollution par le plastique. Il faut repenser l'avenir des plastiques, ce qui est bon pour notre environnement, mais aussi bon pour notre économie et très bon dans la lutte contre les changements climatiques. Tout le monde y gagne.
Solid waste treatment and disposal is responsible for 5% of global emissions. Circular economy can prevent waste generation through product lifetime extension, reuse and repair, recycling and transforming waste into a resource. Lifestyle changes are essential for building circularity and bridging the emissions gap. The richest 1% of the population are responsible for more than twice of the global greenhouse gas emissions when compared to the poorest 50%. We must ensure the transition is just and inclusive, and that the burden is not transferred to the most vulnerable countries and most vulnerable people. More climate ambition is required to achieve the Paris Agreement goals. Circular economy can translate this ambition into action. Visit unep.org/GACERE and learn more about the work of GACERE.